So you guys know this is the last episode before Thanksgiving break. Don't you think it's a good idea if we, film a couple Thanksgiving jib jabs?
Martin, we're not doing any more jib jabs, and there's a
People like them.
reason. No, there's a reason why.
Marty, we well before you got your new iPads, we went ahead and blocked jib jabs. So
We blocked
you can't do them anymore.
People like them.
No, buddy.
Nobody
It's
likes
just
them,
you,
Martin.
buddy. No one else likes those.
Whatever.
Welcome to Smoke Signals, a hard-hitting news program for students by students.
Welcome to Smoke Signals, I'm Tyler.
And I'm Luke Mori. And now we go to a special Explain Yourself.
Hi, I'm Casey Martin with Smoke Signals. I'm here with a special Explain Yourself. We have Ms. Dara Whipple, who is in charge of the FCCLA, what was previously known as the Thanksgiving celebration to end all celebrations, which was a smorgasbord, a cornucopia, if you will, of food that I looked forward to for the last 25 years as a teacher here at THS. Dara has told us that we're not having it this year. Explain yourself.
Casey, when was the last time you cooked a turkey?
That is classified information.
When was the last time you bought a turkey?
Unknown.
This is why we are not having a celebration this year. With the rising cost of turkey, the amount of work it takes, we decided not to host it this year. I'm very sorry. I truly apologize.
Cut.
You will survive.
Go.
Hi, I'm Kelsey Kerwin, and I'm sick this week, but I wanted to give this opportunity to say everyone should go out and vote. Last week, it may have appeared that I wasn't interested in voting. Well, that was part of a skit where I misunderstood Mr. Martin, where I was supposed to act like it was at the end of a football game and I was tired from it. But anyway, everyone should vote. You to vote. It is every American's right to vote. It is very important. So everyone, when you turn 18, register to vote and get out there and rock the vote. Thank you.
What she said.
Go.
On behalf of Smoke Signals, we would just like to thank Connie for our clean bathrooms. We didn't intend to hurt any feelings last week, but you know, sometimes a bathroom smells bad.
So, can we still use the bathrooms?
Yes, just clean up after yourself.
We love you, Connie.
You do a great job, Connie.
Thank you, Connie.
You're welcome.
Thank you. That was very special.
Now we go on to Jarrett and Tanner with student interviews and Kelsey was going to do it, but she's freaking sick like a dingus, so.
It's Jarrett.
It's Tanner.
We're doing student interviews.
Thanksgiving edition. Hi, we're here with Gare Bear. What's your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Ham.
Can you shut the door?
I'm here with V. Cole Anderson, and what is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Stuffing.
Hi, I'm here with Luke. What two NFL teams play every Thanksgiving?
No.
What two NFL teams play on Thanksgiving almost every year?
The Lions and the Cowboys.
Correct.
I'm now here with Faith and Kevlar asking, what is your favorite Thanksgiving food?
Green bean casserole.
I would have to be brown sugar
here. Valid. For Dowdy.
Luke, what's your favorite kind of pie, man?
Coconut cream.
How many Thanksgiving meals do you guys eat?
Two.
Lame.
Thank you. I don't know if they were good, but I hope they were funny. So thank you.
Now we go to Wolfpack Sports with Claire. End of fall seasons and beginning of winter seasons, and junior high sports are in full swing.
What's up, Wolfpack? This is Claire Martin with your week in Wolf Sports. Some volleyball postseason awards. Congratulations to Claire, Lizzie, and Nat for getting all KMA land. Nat was Missouri Player of the Year for KMA and signed with the Washburn Ichabods, and Coach Hagee was the KMA Coach of the Year. The East Atchison Wolves football team finished the season with a record of 9 wins and 2 losses. The Wolves lost the district semifinal to the number 1-ranked North Andrew Cardinals. On a frigid night in Rosendale, the Wolves were able to use a strong running game and stout defense to stay competitive. It was a great season, Wolves. Congratulations. The junior high basketball teams are in full swing. The girls and boys played in the South Holt tournament this week. The girls finished 4th and are now sitting at a record of 4 wins and 6 losses. The boys' junior high team are now sitting at a record of 6-3. The Wolves were able to capture 3rd place in the South Holt tournament this week. Congratulations.
Thanks, Claire.
And now we go on to Dan, where he gets to discover nature. Hopefully it's not about autumn.
This better be creative, Daniel.
There's 4 seasons in a year, but we all know which is best. The beautiful scenery that surrounds us gives us a glimpse of hope before the snow falls. Trees covered from top to bottom with color. The weather is so nice, it makes me want to go for a walk. Thick landscapes of green grass still cover the ground, and colored leaves begin to scatter. As I gaze upon the wonderful blue sky painted through the limbs of this tree, I find an empty home. Its inhabitants, although unknown, have embarked on a journey southward before the first snowfall. As I await this great season to end, I wonder if snow will ever come. Nature truly is amazing, especially during this time of year. It's a great reminder that there is always something to learn.
Dan wrote his script for autumn, and then it snowed. We were so close to the deadline that we went ahead and ran it. So I hope you enjoyed your snowy autumn.
I told you it should have been about autumn.
Yeah, that was May. Well, now we go to top 5 musicals with Claire.
Hey, Smoke Signals, this is Claire, and this week I'm doing your top 5. This week's top 5 is top 5 THS musicals we have done. At number 5, we have Annie Get Your Gun. I loved that one, and I know a few other people did too. Number 4, we have Mamma Mia. Popular one. Love the movie. Play was great. Except it was COVID year, so that was kind of stressful. Number 3, we have West Side Story. Not many of you remember this one, but I loved it, and I know a few other people did too. Number two is probably everyone's favorite, Little Shop of Horrors. Big plant, really cool. Yeah, I liked that one. And now we have some honorable mentions. Thoroughly Modern Millie, Big Fish, and Sister Act. Those were all three great ones, but they didn't make the top five. And number one, we have Chicago. Come watch it this weekend.
Thanks, Claire. Those were some decent choices.
And now we'll take it to Ian, where he gets to talk about the play.
Hello, Smoke Signals. You know, it's been a tough couple of weeks for me personally, and I'm sure anybody that's in the play can relate, but now is the time where we actually perform it and show you guys. So, give you a little overview of what the play's about. It's based in the 1920s. It's in Chicago. The play's called Chicago. It's based in Chicago, and it follows Roxy Hart, a wannabe villain star who murders her lover and is arrested, despite her attempts to convince the pushover husband, Amos, to lie for her. In the Cook County Jail, Roxy meets her hero, the famed double murderess, the nightclub performer Velma Kelly. When they both acquire the same lawyer, the greedy and lustful superstar and sexy Billy Flynn, tensions come to a head as they fight for the spotlight. That's pretty much it. That's good music. I'll interview some of the cast members, but you guys should definitely come and see the play. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday.
So I'm here with Apple, and I'm also here with Mrs. Barnett. She helps a lot when it comes to the plays, and so I play Billy Flynn, right?
Yes, you do. You do a good job, Billy Flynn.
Can we both admit that it's probably the best, like the best person who's ever done a play is like me. Like I'm the best actor you've ever had, and Billy Flynn's probably the best character that's ever been in a play.
I'll go with you're the best actor, but I'm not sure Billy Flynn's the best character.
Who do you think is better than Billy Flynn?
I don't know, that'd take me a while to figure out. Yeah. Can I have a bite of the apple?
No.
Okay.
Now, we're going to bring back a very special segment. It's actually everyone's favorite, Tyler Talks.
So for those of you who don't know, this is probably all of you, I just straight up refuse to watch scary movies. But for Smoke, I'll make an exception. After a quick talk with Martin and most of the Smokecast, I've decided that I'm going to watch a spooky movie tonight, and you're going to see the beginning, which is right now, the middle, and the end. So, let's get right into it.
It's the freaking demon.
Did it get you?
Yeah, it did, bro.
The hands.
Hey, you took your blindfold off. I went. You weren't even warm, Mom.
Why are you going down there, bro? Oh.
Oh my god, that was awesome.
You're not gonna bang on the door or nothing?
So there's silence. I would rather be dead.
No, I saw something come up.
Anyone else hear that child laugh?
Mm-hmm. I'd rather have broken my neck on the fall.
Alright, Tyler, we're halfway through the movie. Thoughts?
It's pretty spooky, I would say. I'm kind of freaked out, and I don't know if I'll be able to drive home tonight and or sleep in my bedroom. So.
Scared, 1 to 10?
Right now, a solid 8. It really just amped up right before this happened, so.
All right, we'll check back in at the end of the movie.
All right.
Oh my god, it's in those. Did you not fall into the right part of the cellar?
Yeah. Under the house.
I look away, but I'm glued to the screen. Yep. Is that it?
Did you not hear the rope hanging?
Swing down. Holy god. Turning, bro. It's turning.
All right, so what'd you think of the film?
Although it was probably one of the scariest pieces of media I have ever consumed, it was a solid film, solid plot, good scares. I will admit I jumped a few times, but out of 10, I would give the movie a solid like 9 overall. It was really good. Would I watch again by myself? No. Would I watch it with my friends again? Yeah.
So was it that bad?
No, not really. I faced my fears. My fears have been conquered. Thanks, me.
Well, after weeks, months, years of complaining, Connor finally gets the anchor spot. We go to Tarkio's Got Talent with Connor.
I was in my math class, gazing at my hopeless peers. I realized that it had been generations since Tarkio had any special qualities. Our facilities were desolate, with no future in sight. Emptiness filled our vending machine, as well as my heart. There seemed to be no activity anymore. And the awards that I found were ancient. But before all hope was lost, I stumbled upon something I will never forget. In the shimmer of light, I saw a room of opportunity. I had a lot to do with no time to waste. I'm taking matters into my own hands now, hoping for a bright future ahead.
Thank you, Connor, and thank you guys for watching. You guys may have noticed I look different. I lost a little bit of weight, and Tyler's been like this for 20 minutes, so.
I look really cool. I smell like backstage right now.
He does smell like backstage.
I was thinking of Kelsey, and then I was thinking of Jarrett, and then I was thinking of Tanner. And
he's like, which one is it?
Smoke Signals, this is Claire, and I'm here doing your top 5. This week, are you kidding me?
What?
Wow.
Wolfpack.
When I say number 1 is Chicago, I mean Chicago from Victorious, the one-woman show by Trina Vega.
No one watched the ass. You told me
Chicago! Hey, Hey, Smoke Signals, this is Claire, and I'm here doing your top five this week. This week's top five is top five THS musicals.
This is how the magic happens.
You owe me money.
Thanks, Dan. It's Montana. Do your job.